Hi, this is Nuresh Mirani from Analyze India. I write on nureshtech.co.in and I've been doing so for the last few years. So starting up again with a few video presentations. So let us look at the current topic, which you're looking at, the 200-day moving average. Now, this is something which has been talked about across various technical analysis forums as well as on business channels or in newspapers without even looking at the fact that a 200-day moving average, which is supposed to be a yearly average, has actually changed over the last 50 to 100 years, but we are still using the same. So in the last 50 to 100 years, we had something like 200 days trading sessions in a year, but nowadays we have 240 to 260 trading sessions across the world in a year. But have we shifted down from 200 to 250, 260? Not really. So what happens is, this has become a reference value for a lot of people, so we end up using the same. So that's how it goes. So let us look at how it should work. So generally, people believe a stock above its 200-day moving average is in an uptrend, and a stock below its 200-day moving average is in a downtrend. Now, that is the worst way to decide whether a stock has changed trends. So I would stick to the simpler system of higher bottoms and higher tops to decide whether a trend has been established, and then look at the 200-day moving average. So in this case, if we look at this scenario, in the year of 2013, we were basically stuck up around 5,000 to 6,000 levels. And if you would have used the 200-day moving average as our criteria to trade, we would have been whipsawed quite a few times. So in this case, if we look at it, there was a whipsaw out here, there was a whipsaw out here, then one more here, and this one was a very big one. So you would have sold here and again bought here, and again sold on the next day. So there were almost 2 to 3 whipsaws. So if you are looking at it on a very simpler formation of buying above the 200-day moving average and selling below it. Similarly, during the period of 2012, we got another big whipsaw. So what we say is, when should we look at the 200-day moving average? So generally, I would prefer to start looking at the 200-day moving average when a trend has been established on the upside or on the downside. So if you look at this chart, we crossed a multi-year high around 6300, 6500. Now there were two major tops around 6300 in 2008, 2010, and we saw almost 3 attempts in 2013, and then we broke out. So this was a clear-cut indication of a higher top, higher bottom formation and a new trend being established. So since then, we have continued in a higher top, higher bottom. So now it becomes important to look at the 200-day moving average, which is at around 80 to 30, 80 to 50 levels. So that could be a good area to look at for support zones. Now let us look at when a similar trend was formed, a major trend change, and how is the 200-day moving average acted. So we saw a major trend change somewhere in 2019, where we broke out of this triangle and started a new uptrend. Post that, we crossed the 200-day moving average. In the next two attempts on corrections, 200-day did act as a strong support area with a little whipsaw below it. So that shows that the level is not sacrosanct, wherein it would not be an exact support level, but rather an area where you have to start looking to deploy cash or buy on dips. Similarly, if you look at the biggest uptrend which we had in our markets was in 2003 to 2007, and majorly between 2005 to 2007. This started when we broke a multi-year high somewhere at 2000 to 2300 Nifty levels. So somewhere here was a clear-cut trend setup, or maybe you could say somewhere it was here where we started off at 1700 Nifty. In both the cases, if you look at it, all through the rally of 2005 to 2007, we had first support here at the 200-day moving average. Now this was a much bigger dip, wherein we fell below the 200-day moving average but did not sustain for long. In the next dip as well, now this was a sharp correction of 30%, but again this two dips. But if we notice, if we believe in the longer term trend, you could have taken this 5-10% hit after your entry point, but over the next couple of years you would have made a lot of money. Now this trend got reversed somewhere in 2008. In the first attempt, it did not close below the 200-day moving average. And post that, we got a clear-cut signal out here, and post that, we see the 200-day moving average ended up as a resistance. So what it tells you is we can see a 5% dip on the max side below the 200-day moving average. But if you believe in the longer term uptrend, a dip to the 200-day moving average should actually be an opportunity to deploy fresh capital, as well as, say, if you have some cash which is out of booked profits, you can start looking to deploy the same. So I believe the next couple of weeks or more could be a good time to deploy cash, as well as make a list of stocks which you would like to buy, and hope that it comes down to your buying area. But at least this could be a good time to watch out for opportunities. So let's hope we get a lot of opportunities over the next couple of weeks. Even though Nifty may or may not give you that opportunity, a lot of stocks would have come down. As you see, a lot of stocks are down 20-30% from the recent peaks, although the Nifty is down around 6-8%. So you have a list of stocks and a list of opportunities over the next few weeks. So let's hope, if you believe the bull market, this is a good time. That's it from me.